As we have seen what is shear stress in circular pipe for a pipe containing laminar flow, let us see what is velocity distribution of that part. So, now let us see what is velocity distribution for a laminar flow in a circular pipe. So, for that, we'll consider a circular pipe for having some cross-sectional area, that is dA. So now we have this cross-sectional area or a circular pipe in which we have drawn the front view, and we are going to see what is velocity distribution. Previously we have seen that is this was shear stress distribution for a laminar flow. Now, that was governed by the equation tau is equals to minus dou p by dou x into r by 2. So, over here, dou p by dou x was a constant term. So, we wrote tau is equals to minus k times r by 2. Now, as we increase the radius from the center to the circumference, that is from r is equals to 0 to r is equals to capital R, we had seen the shear stress gradually increases, but the direction of shear stress is in the opposite direction. That is what is the significance of negative sign. Now, we also know that according to Newton's law of viscosity, shear stress tau is equals to mu into du by dy. Over here, there is change in velocity with respect to y. Tau is equals to mu into du by dy. Now, we see this is velocity gradient, that is changing. Velocity is changing with respect to y, that is y coordinate. But we have considered this in cylindrical coordinate system. Now, let us change this from this rectangular coordinate system, that is dy, to cylindrical coordinate system. Now, we'll consider that is y, that is distance from the wall, that is this distance is y, and that can be written as y is equals to, that is capital R minus small r, capital R minus small r. Now, if you differentiate this with respect to r, that is dy by dr is equals to, this will be minus 1, and dy will be equals to minus dr. So now we have changed this from rectangular coordinate system to radial or cylindrical coordinate system just by changing the differential dy by minus dr. So the Newton's law of viscosity, tau will be equals to mu into du by minus dr. So now we can plug in this value in this equation and we can calculate the value of velocity. So now let us substitute this. So according to Newton's law, tau is equals to mu into du by minus dr, and what we have written in the previous part, that is tau is equals to minus dou p by dou r into dou p by dou x into r by 2. So we have seen two values of shear stress, that is tau is equals to mu du by dr, that is minus dr, and tau is equals to minus dou p by dou x into r by 2. So now let us substitute the value of tau in terms of the other. So what do we get? That is minus of dou p by dou x into r by 2, that is equals to mu into du by minus dr. These two minus signs will go away and we'll be left with this entire equation. So now we have to calculate the velocity. So let us keep velocity on one side and let us take all the other terms on the other side. So what do we get over here? That is du is equals to, that is dou p by dou x into r by 2, into dr will come in the numerator, that is dr, and mu will come in the denominator. So now let us see and solve this equation. Now this is a differential equation in terms of r and dr, that is velocity is a function of radial coordinate, that is r. So now if you solve this differential equation, we need to have its boundary conditions. So let us see in the diagram what boundary conditions we come across. So in the diagram we can check over here, the boundary conditions will be in terms of small r, that is r is equals to 0 and r is equals to capital R. So at these boundaries we need to know the velocity of the fluid, but we know that just in contact with the entire pipe, the velocity at small r is equals to capital R, that will be equals to 0. So over here at radius is equals to capital R, the velocity is 0. We have to calculate what is the velocity at the initial position, that is R is equals to 0. So now we have our boundary condition, that is we have just one boundary condition over here, that is when small r is equals to capital R, the velocity is equals to 0. So now let us calculate this part, that is integrate this, integrate du is equals to integral of 1 upon mu into dou p by dou x into r by 2 into dr. Now if I integrate this, so this will be the velocity u, and if I integrate this, 1, 2, 3, 4 terms are constants, so this will be 1 upon 2 mu into dou p by dou x into what we'll get over here, that is integral of r into dr, that is r square by 2 plus c. Now let us substitute the boundary condition in this equation and let us see what do we get. So let us write down this equation again. So u equals to, that is 1 upon 2 mu dou p by dou x into r square by 2 plus c. Now we are substituting the value of small r, that is equals to capital R, and there the velocity is equals to 0. So if you substitute the value, so what do we get? This part as 0 is equals to 1 upon 2 mu dou p by dou x into r square by 2 plus c. So c will have a value of minus 1 upon 2 mu dou p by dou x, dou p by dou x into capital R square. So we have got the value of c is equals to minus 1 upon 2 mu dou p by dou x into R square by 2. Now let us substitute this entire term in this equation number 1. So what do we get? That is u is equals to, that is 1 upon 4 mu into dou p by dou x into r square minus of 1 upon 4 mu into dou p by dou x into capital R square. Now in this entire equation we can take these three terms, that is 1 upon 4 mu dou p by dou x as common, and we will be left with one equation, that is u equals to 1 upon 4 mu dou p by dou x into small r square minus capital R square. Now this is the velocity distribution for a laminar flow in a circular pipe. Now if you consider the value of u minimum and u maximum, let us check whether we get as 0 or not. Okay, so we have this equation as, we have this equation as u is equals to, that is 1 upon 4 mu dou p by dou x into small r square minus capital R square. Now let us see what do we have at the boundaries, what value we have of velocity at the boundaries. So now over here this is small r is equals to 0, this is small r is equals to capital R. Here the velocity we'll try to calculate. If you substitute the value of r is equals to capital R, then you will get this as 0. So that means at r is equals to capital R, u is equals to u minimum, that is equals to 0. And when r is equals to 0, u will be equals to, let us substitute this r value as 0. So the u will be equals to minus 1 upon 4 mu dou p by dou x into capital R square. So this is the maximum velocity. So u max will be when velocity will be equals to u max when r will be equals to 0. Now, if we want to plot this velocity, this is actually parabolic in nature. So if you plot the graph, at the extreme points the velocity will be 0 and in between the velocity will be maximum, and the graph over here will be a parabolic graph and this will go ahead because velocity is maximum in between and velocity is 0 at both the ends. So this is what is velocity distribution in laminar flow. Now we can write over here that u is equals to minus 1 upon 4 mu into dou p by dou x into r square. So this part, this entire part remains constant. So this entire part remains constant in this equation and u is just a function of r square. Hence we have a parabolic curve over here. I hope you have understood what is velocity distribution in laminar flow of a circular pipe. Thank you.